From the potential of more Earths being out there to the potential for new space colonies, join me as I reveal to you recent discoveries from space. Number 8. Water on Mars. The idea of water on Mars is not new. In fact, there have been finds that said that Mars used to have water, and that gave us hope for new chances to explore Mars and be on Mars one day. Which is why scans from the Mars Reconnaissance Orbital in 2018 were so important, for it discovered that formations on the planet were actually caused by water that is still there right now. This was a confirmation based on a finding of hydrated salts on certain slopes of the planet. Our quest on Mars has been to follow the water in our search for life in the universe. And now we have convincing science that validates what we've long suspected, said John Grunsfeld, astronaut and associate administrator of NASA's science mission Directorate in Washington. This is a significant development as it appears to confirm that water, albeit briny, is flowing today on the surface of Mars. That's huge, because water on Mars right now means that it could be changed and altered to support ingestion, which is the endgame goal here in regards to colonizing the planet. It took multiple spacecraft over several years to solve this mystery, and now we know there is liquid water on the surface of this cold desert planet, said Michael Meyer, lead scientist for NASA's Mars Exploration Program at the agency's headquarters in Washington. It seems that the more we study Mars, the more we learn how life could be supported and where there are resources to support life in the future. This was one big step for man for sure, but it wasn't the only discovery on Mars in the last year. Number 7. Black holes and imagery of them. Black holes are a very curious thing in our universe, because they are one of the most destructive forces ever made. And yet, it's still a bit unclear how they exist, and how they work is very well known though. They're entities with such heavy gravitational field that even light can't escape them, which is why they're literal black holes, because you can't see into them via the light not being able to project out of them. In the last year, there have been two rather big discoveries in terms of black holes. First, there is indeed a supermassive black hole in the center of the Milky Way galaxy called Sagittarius A, and that it's apparently surrounded by a bunch of other black holes, up to 10,000 apparently, which would make that part of our universe one of the most deadly in the world. Then in April 2019, scientist Katie Booman was about to actually get the first visible picture of a black hole. This stunned the community because of its beauty and intensity, and how it looks in the eye of Sauron from Lord of the Rings, but I digress. All of this points to how we're slowly but surely growing in our knowledge of these entities. Number 6. Organic matter on Mars. Life on Mars, something that many people have thought about, talked about, dreamed about, and most importantly, imagined about via TV shows, movies, and more. But in June of 2018, proof that there might be life on Mars, or that there was life on Mars, was found, as one of the Mars rovers was researching a 3-billion-year-old mudstone and found organic matter, as in it found life, in part. With these new findings, Mars is telling us to stay the course and keep searching for evidence of life, said Thomas Zurbuchen, Associate Administrator for the Science Mission Directorate at NASA headquarters. I'm confident that our ongoing and planned missions will unlock even more breathtaking discoveries on the Red Planet. Add this to the fact that there have now been confirmed findings of methane in the Martian atmosphere, meaning that it can form an organic construct, and it would seem to indicate that life on Mars isn't as impossible as once believed. And now the hunt is on for even more material, and even more proof that life either is or was on the Red Planet, and whether we can use what we find to help get humanity there one day. Number 5. Death of Saturn's rings. When you think of the planet Saturn, your mind likely goes right to its rings, right? After all, they're a defining feature, and they're something that really helps make the planet stand out. Not to mention, the rings are both massive and beautiful, making it a planet many want to study. Yet it's because of these studies that it's been discovered that the rings of Saturn are dying. How does that happen? How can rings of a massive size die? Well, according to NASA, the rings are losing the moisture in the rocks that form the rings. The moisture itself is being pulled into the planet itself. So because of the loss of moisture, the rocks are breaking down. And when they break down far enough, they'll cease to exist. We are lucky to be around to see Saturn's ring system, which appears to be in the middle of its lifetime. Lead author James O'Donohue, a space physicist at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center, said in a statement, "However, if rings are temporary, perhaps we just missed out on seeing giant ring systems of Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune, which have only thin ringlets today. But if you're worried about the rings suddenly vanishing overnight, you have nothing to fear. It is believed it will take another 300 million years for the rings to fully vanish. However, NASA has said that while their prediction is accurate based on various figures, should the rate of moisture absorption continue to grow, it would accelerate the process." Number 4. Getting into Jupiter's orbit. NASA has long tried to get a spacecraft into Jupiter's orbit, and it's not hard to see why given the unique nature of Jupiter, as well as its massive size. However, because of conditions in the planet's atmosphere, it's very difficult, not to mention getting a craft near the planet in terms of its position in space is also hard, given its distance from Earth and the time it would take to get there. Thankfully, though, on July 4, 2016, the Juno was the first spacecraft to make it into Jupiter's orbit, an accomplishment so grand, even NASA said it was hard for them to pull off. If you're curious about the craft that made this journey, the Juno is a solar-powered spacecraft, and it was sent to Jupiter to learn more about the planet through pictures, videos, and scan. Already, it has sent back video of storms taking place on the surface of Jupiter, as well as a volcanic eruption happening on the nearby moon of Io. Now, should these scans and studies continue without incident, it's very possible that we'll learn more about Jupiter than we have ever before, and that could lead to some very interesting discoveries, but only time will tell if that'll happen in good time. Number 3. Comet Soup. NASA sent their Deep Impact spacecraft into a comet called Tempe 1 in 2005. You heard that, right? NASA actually made one of their craft collide with an actual comet. Pretty weird, huh? But I promise there was a purpose. They did it because they wanted to analyze the content and particles that were released from the impact. The comet itself was thought to have existed near the beginning of our solar system, and thus NASA wanted to see what the comet was made of, as it would give clues as to what was out there during the beginning, or the perceived beginning at least. So what did the craft reveal about the comet soup? The scans revealed that it was filled with things like silicates, clay, carbonates, iron-bearing compounds, and aromatic hydrocarbons, some of which are things that we use to this day on Earth. So does this paint a better picture about Earth? Yes and no. We do have a slightly more filled-in picture, but it's still something that needs to be investigated further to understand truly what was out there in the beginning. Still, it's a step, and a good one at that. Number 2. Ice volcanoes. And you thought the volcanoes on Earth were bad? Well, on the dwarf planet, a planet that never matured to full size called Ceres, it may have ice volcanoes. Yeah, that's right, ice volcanoes. That could well and truly be a thing. This was discovered by NASA via their Dawn spacecraft in 2015, which was observing Ceres, which orbits between Mars and Jupiter for the record. These are called cryovolcanoes, because instead of fire and ash, they could potentially shoot out ice and mud. How do we know this? Observation of Ceres helped prove that the planet is covered with ice both above and below its surface. To that end, should these structures erupt, the only thing it can shoot is ice and mud, because that's the only thing around it. The members of the Dawn science team expected a lot of things, but not what we finally got, says Ralph Jumann of the German Aerospace Center. "I was completely surprised, and completely means completely. At present, one of these cryovolcanoes haven't had an eruption in view of the craft, but given all the other weird things that are out there, such as a planet that rains glass, no joke, it's not so far of a stretch to think that an ice volcano could be out there." Number 1. Other Earths. One of the biggest wishes of man is to find another planet like Earth where we can go and settle should we need to leave our own planet. And should we actually have the technology to do so? But let's not dwell on that right now. Well, it was discovered by NASA in February 2017 that there might be seven Earth-like planets in a place just outside our own galaxy. In fact, all seven planets inhabit one galaxy. As you hopefully know, Earth is a very special planet. It has an atmosphere that has oxygen, amongst other gases, and thus allows life to breathe and grow. It is orbiting a sun that doesn't bombard our planet with too much heat, nor does it give it too little. This is why finding another Class M planet, as they are called, has been so rare. Because what we need to survive is very specific. Yet they seem to have found seven of these kinds of planets that are orbiting a dwarf star called TRAPPIST-1. According to images, they are about the same size as Earth. And some of them, based on pictures and scans, do appear to have water on their own. Should this be true, and should we be able to reach them, this could be a major colonization option for Earth. Plus, should this water be like ours, it is reasonable to expect there to be life within that water. And if that's true, it'll be the first life outside of Earth to be discovered. The possibilities here are very interesting, not just because we might have found another planet to live on, but we might have found a bunch to live on in a very short area. Which means that could be heading to a place where we could inhabit lots of planets, and yet not be that far from each other. Sure, it's still a pipe dream right now, but it may not be later. What did you think about these new discoveries that NASA and others have found over the last few years? Which ones do you think will truly change things for us in regards on how we view space and its possibilities? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe. And I'll see you next time.